quick Uber ride from the airport lands me in front of my truck. I guess all that's left now is to get in this thing and go to Des Moines. It's about 3:15. We're stopped for the night. Parked that dude just a little bit ago. A couple hours, we go right in that door right there.
Root, root, root.
For the Cubbies, they don't win.
Thank you very much.
have cookies here like they did in Minnesota in Minneapolis. And they sell them by the bucket, just like they did there, but they're not as good. I had to.
Des Moines sits where the Raccoon River and the Des Moines River meet and flow into one. Downtown Des Moines is laid out on a grid. It's easy to navigate. There's not a lot of traffic. We were there for 6 days and never encountered a lot of traffic. Easily walkable. It's actually a excellent biking center. You can get all over Des Moines on a bicycle. There's bicycle paths everywhere. There is art and fountains and parks around every corner in downtown. You can turn a corner and look at another mural or a sculpture or a fountain. You can find great restaurants within walking distance of your hotel downtown. The ball field is in walking distance of downtown. It's a wonderful place to go visit. If you've got the time, put Des Moines on your list.
This skywalk thing is the coolest thing ever.
That orange line, you could go anywhere in the city, like 8-9 blocks, 4 blocks wide.
So I talked to a security guy in here and he said it's for the weather really, because Des Moines gets over 100 in the summer and it gets below zero real quick in the wintertime. So this is how they get around downtown, which is pretty fantastic.
So the story goes, Sara Lee bought out Colonial Grid several years ago, and in early 2000s, they closed down the company.
The bakery has been repurposed for a school facilities kitchen, but you can go by and get you a picture of the sign.